Where's Mrs. O'Regan?
Oh, she's checking the delivery out the back. Can we help you, Mrs. Powell?
No, it's just a routine round.
Oh, what are you doing?
No, I'm fine.
Oh, Mrs. Powell, they're waiting for you in reception.
Sorry, I forgot the time.
Oh, hey, Mrs. Powell, you better have this back. I mean, we wouldn't want you getting caught with it, so I put it in a safer place in your pocket, eh?
I just confiscated that. How dare you take it?
I've got a job for you.
Like what?
Make sure Manning gets this. Break it into his food or drink.
What is it?
Something that will make him go to the toilet.
Now, why would you want to do that?
Is that the lunch bell?
Oh, yes, Mr. Manning. Oh, hey, Mr. Manning, now don't forget your milk. Got it all ready for you in the fridge.
Oh, thanks, Cass. I don't have time.
Oh, I need to take a peek.
Hey, look, I'll get it. I'll get it.
Those blokes out there.
Yeah, right, see? Here, Mr. Manning, that should keep you going.
Geez, you took long enough. Here you go, Mr. Manning.
Look, that's not pain. Get to the dining room.
Oh.
Hey, come on, Cass. Look, what's the long face for? It was an accident, all right?
Oh, yeah, but Mr. Manning, I'm going to get you in stripe walking around all dirty like that.
No worries, Cass. I've got another jacket in my locker. But we better get this lot cleaned up, eh?
Yeah. Oh, hey, look, Harry's giving us a hand.
Yeah, well, we better get him out quick. Mrs. O catches him in here, she'll put him in the stew pot.
Oh, yeah. You'd be so tough, wouldn't you, Harry? You'd rust a tooth. Scraggy old pusscat.
Yeah, well, if she'd taken as many nips as you said she had, there wouldn't have been much left anyway.
Might have killed the taste of this mutton.
On the plates. Now, come on, get this line moving.
I can't, Miss Ferguson. See, it's stuck in here.
Well, Burns, if you haven't got what it takes, maybe we can put you back on cleaning duties.
Oh, there you go, Jude. Want some, Miss Ferguson?
Oh, no, I wouldn't if I were you, Miss Ferguson. This one is known as O'Regan's Revenge.
That's why I was offering it.
Get moving, Brian.
You really are pushing your luck, aren't you, Burns? Then I always did prefer to deal with you when there were less people around.
Jeez, doll, what are you trying to do? Sign your death warrant?
And you can just wipe that smirk right off your face, Brian.
What was all that about?
Doreen, she's gone over the top.
What else is new? They tell you about Powell?
Yeah, poor bitch, eh?
Mm, my sentiments, exactly. I reckon I'd hit the bottle too if it happened to me. How do you think she's going to react with us knowing?
Well, it might make her a bit more careful. Can you imagine what the freak would do to her if she found her drunk on duty?
Bye-bye, perfect.
You bet.
Hey, come on, it wasn't my fault. That dumb idiot just piped on the whole lot flying.
Then I guess it will teach me to trust someone with your mentality.
What is the big deal anyway? There's lots of stuff you can nick around here to give someone the trots. God, the food's enough.
Go on, get back to your moronic mate.
Good God, what have you been up to?
Well, just getting out the worst of it. Small accident with a glass of milk.
Have you had any lunch yet?
No, I've been snacking all morning. I'll give it a miss.
How are they getting on with the PA installations?
Just about done, I'd say. In fact, I'd better get back. They'll be finished their break. Colleen's with them at the moment.
No, I told her to go home. She looked washed out. I think we'll have to organise the roster so that she has shorter hours, at least until she gets over the shock.
Yeah, well, I hope she's stronger than I am, because I don't think I'll ever get over it.
Look, Rick, I can understand how you feel. Just give it time. You can't forget it, but at least you can learn to live with it.
How true. Well, back to the treadmill.
Rick, Inspector Maynard rang. He's coming in to see you this afternoon.
Oh, thanks.
Well, watch it, will you?
Sorry, just doing me job.
Gee.
Hey, I like your hair today. Yeah, it's not much different. Must be after something. Oh, hell, you maybe missed me favourite track.
It's a neat sort of a gadget. Just have a look.
Oh, yeah. Hang on, there. Listen to that one. Just press the play button. Great, aren't they?
There's nothing happening. How long before it comes on?
You must have stuffed it up.
What do you mean? I didn't do a thing.
Yeah, you pressed the wrong button and now there's a bloody great gap. And us talking right through the middle of me favourite Clash track.
Well, you'd rather have my voice, wouldn't you? Keep you company during the middle of the night.
Get lost.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah? Well, just don't go scratching your head, fella. You'll get splinters.
Yeah, up yours too, kiddo.
God, will you get a load of misery, Guts? God, I'd love to know what she and Glory were talking about over lunch.
Why? It hasn't done her much good by the look of her. What's wrong with you, love?
Oh, that idiot Ian just stuffed up me Clash tape.
Oh, poor guy. And I was available too.
It's not funny. How am I going to get another one? Just tell me that.
Okay, calm down. What did he do?
Oh, I just started recording over the top, that's all.
Be an improvement, wouldn't it? I'm sorry.
Listen, I didn't know you could record on that thing.
Oh, of course you can. It's ace. Well, me and Sonia even got...
Aren't you supposed to be working, Mitchell?
Shucks.
Here, let me see how it works.
After I've taken the tape out.
Take it easy.
Right.
Is there something you don't want us to know about, Sonia?
Let's just say it's none of your business, Brian.
Okay, let's say that. But you leave Bobby out of any of your future plans. Do you understand me?
Now, where the hell have you been? You're supposed to come back here straight after lunch.
I got held up. But look what I got for after.
Oh, yeah. Let's have it down.
How'd you get it past Manny?
Oh, he went off somewhere and I thought he'd catch me with it, but I got the lot. It's unreal, you know. I could walk straight out the front gate and nobody would stop me.
You're amazing, Doreen.
Yeah, how come we never see stuff like this? I thought we were supposed to eat the same things as the screws.
Yeah, well, I reckon Ferguson eats the same as us. That's why she's always griping. Oh, Sonia, I saved this for you. Sit on it.
Oh, God. Now, listen, speaking of pleasure, there must be some way that I can get together with me mate Bird. You got any ideas?
No chance. The screws are watching them like hawks.
Oh, I know. But if we were to create a diversion and get their tiny little minds onto something else...
God, Helen.
Oh, come on, Jude. I'm an artiste. I have to practice. God, I've been starved for months in here. Well, you know what I mean.
So, you know about Eddie's fake death, the works, eh?
We've been after these boys for quite a while now. Eddie was getting pretty close. Until you came along. Almost blew the whole show on us.
Yeah, well, thanks heaps, mate. And you might have let me in on it. I thought you were crook.
It was better for Eddie if you didn't know.
So, why fill me in now? He is all right, isn't he?
No. There's been a leak from my department. They've told fellows that Eddie's still alive.
Oh, great. Well, I can tell you where the leak is, if that's why you're here. Birmingham and Mears.
Yeah, well, I know how you feel about these.
Feel? Things. It's not what I feel, it's what I know. Look, those two have been taken with both hands for years.
Listen to me. I know what you're talking about. And you also know that these things have to be proven.
So how about Eddie? Is he in danger or...?
Oh, we're keeping him well tucked up out of sight. Has there been any attempt to get at you while you've been sleeping over here?
Nothing.
Well, just watch yourself. Phyllis is getting pretty nervous. He's got all sorts of feelers out about this info about Eddie still being alive. I reckon if he gets hold of either one of you, you're dead men.
Jeez. Shocking day. Oh. Ah, g'day, Harry. You're snatching 40 winks, you lazy old puss.
What's the matter with you? Harry's dead.
Who's Harry?
That cat.
Oh, is that all?
Mr. Manning made me put him out when he got stuck into that spilt milk. Must have had a heart attack or something because he was all right then. Oh, poor little Harry, he was a nice cat.
Yeah.
Oh, well, I better go tell Mrs. O'Regan. Oh, hey, and Mr. Manning. Oh, he'll be upset. He was real fond of Harry.
Hello, Cass. Oh. What's the matter?
Oh, little Harry's dead, Mr. Manning. Found him just now and I took the rubbish out.
Oh, no. Are you okay?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'm okay. Well, I mean, I'm very sad that he's dead, but everything dies sooner or later, doesn't it? Just didn't think he was that old.
Oh, that's no good. Well, I suppose I can see he gets a decent burial for you.
Oh, would you? Mrs. O'Regan wants you to get rid of him, but she just wants you to put him in the dump, Master.
No, we won't do that. Well, do you want to give me a hand?
Oh, could I? I always used to give the cats and dogs at home little burials, you know, put a little plant on their grave and all that. You reckon we could do that for Harry?
Yeah, Harry deserves the best.
You know, I've been thinking, we can have a bit of fun with that machine of Bobby's.
Hey, Bobby!
Oh, you're wasting your breath, love. She can't hear a thing. Would you have a look at her? Now that I've got to try.
Oh, dear. Come on, Jude. You're going to do yourself a dreadful injury.
Oh, dear.
Making fun of me or something?
No, of course not.
Listen, Bobby, you gave me an idea before. Can we borrow that machine to tape the freak?
No. She catches you with it, she'll smash it. Stan just fixed it after Red busted it.
But you taped her before and got away with it, didn't you?
Yeah, but she wouldn't fall for it again.
Of course she would. Now, you just trust your auntie Helen.
What do you want to tape her for anyway?
Yeah, what are you cooking up?
An idea for a bit of a laugh. I want to tape the freak losing her cool.
Now that is no laugh.
Yeah, but you mix it with my old mate Bert having a bit of a chat, we could come up with something better than the Goon Show.
Hey, yeah, I'd be in that, and if I got the freak angry enough, I'd get my extra 2 weeks. Come on, Bobby, can we have a lend?
Oh, look, I don't know.
Oh, we'll look after it, Bobby, promise.
Yeah, come on, Bobby. Oh, get me out of an awful mess.
All right.
Oh, good. Get him off. Get him off.
Hey, come on, girls. That bell's gone. If you want to get out of this steam factory today, you better pack up.
Oh, yes, ma'am.
Doreen.
Oh, Miss Ferguson, would you do me a favor and put that away while
Certainly,
you do?
Governor.
Thank you. Well, Mr. Simpson, how's it going?
Not bad. We've struck a bit of a hitch, though. It's going to take us a lot longer than we reckoned on.
What sort of a hitch?
Oh, I don't know. Bert's checking it out now. But we're going to have to do a lot more rewiring.
Well, just how long do you think it's going to take?
Oh, a couple of days, maybe. Hard to say, really. These things take time if you want a good job.
Well, just do the best you can.
Righto.
Probably spinning the job out to get more money.
Perhaps, but we have to give them the benefit of the doubt if we want that PA system installed.
Yeah. And then we have another nuisance on our hands.
Sonia, I've got to talk to you. Come in here. Don't want the whole bloody world hearing.
Hearing what?
The cat's dead. It drank some of that milk that got spilt.
So, why the hysterics? A cat is dead.
Don't act dumb with me, lady. That must have been some kind of poison you gave me to slip Manning. Why the hell didn't you tell me?
Well, if you'd known, would you have done it?
Of course I bloody wouldn't. Look, I might be a lot of things, but I'm not a killer. God, you're a cold bitch. Look at you. You couldn't care less.
So it was strong enough to kill a cat. It would have made Manning sick for a few days.
Oh, bull.
Believe what you want.
You bet I will. And I'll make sure the right people hear about it too. You're crazy, you know that.
Payne, I thought you'd been warned about what happens to laggers in here.
Yeah, but this
but
is... But
nothing. Now, you gave the milk to Manning. How on earth are you going to prove that I had anything to do with it? You'd be very foolish to talk to anyone for two reasons. One, no one would believe you. And two, well, I might just slip one of those capsules into your glass of milk. Now get out of here.
What's this for?
This started.
Would you?
Yeah, don't turn it on until you have to.
Jeez, oh, Bobby.
Oh, I just don't want you stuffing nothing up or...
Oh, yeah, well, it's a blank tape.
I know that, but I just don't want you to go dropping it or nothing.
Look,
I won't drop it, I won't jump on it, I won't even flush it down the loo if you don't want me to. Now go away and stop making me nervous. I've got to be ready for when the freak comes in.
Yeah, all right.
Don't frown, you'll get wrinkles.
Helen, how do you reckon I look, you know, me face?
Nothing the paper bag wouldn't fix.
Come on, be serious. Do you reckon a nice bloke would ever go for me?
Well, you'd never turn me on, love, but I reckon if you fixed yourself up, all the nice blokes would be falling over themselves.
You're not just putting me on or nothing?
Of course not. Well, you tone this down a bit and, you know, you could really look something.
Will you help me? You know, really look good.
Of course I will, but it seems a bit of a waste of time in here. I mean, the only bloke worth looking at's... Oh. This nice bloke wouldn't happen to be Manning?
Well, I know he's not too crash off, but it wouldn't hurt to practice on him.
Look, sweetheart, of course I will help you fix yourself up, but I would hate to see you fallen for a screw.
Jeez, what do you think I am?
Okay, now, this is just a word of warning. Most of the screws in here aren't even human.
Come on, you lot. Didn't you hear the bell?
See what I mean?
Will you help me, though?
Yes, of course I will. Straight after dinner.
I'm on Second City.
Well, what have we got here? All right, Burns, you heard me. Come on, get a move on. Get those ridiculous things off and stop wasting my time.
Huh?
Don't get smart with me. Now, you take them off before I rip them off myself.
Be with you in a minute. Can't hear you.
That's just not good enough.
Oh, careful.
Oh, were you saying something, Miss Ferguson?
Yes, Burns, I was saying you've just lost buy-up.
Oh, I already lost buy-up this week.
Well, then consider it lost for another week. Now, get out.
Bloody hell, what has a girl got to do to get a charge around here?
Don't worry about it, kid. We got it.
Poor Harry. Under your feet one minute, brown bread the next.
Yeah, I'm real sorry about it, Cass.
But you're okay about it, aren't you?
Oh, yeah.
Had to go sometime, didn't he?
Hey, it was a real nice little funeral. Mr. Manning was terrific. We're going to plant a bush on his grave after.
Oh, that's lovely.
Hey, can I tell you Mr. Manning offered to bury Harry without me even asking?
He's a nice guy, isn't he?
Yeah, I reckon. Oh, I think I'll go to me dorm.
What about your dinner?
No, no. You can have it, Helen.
There you go, Dawn. I'm feeling real generous.
Oh, gee, thanks.
I think our Cass has got the hots for Mr. Manning. Did you notice?
She wouldn't be the only one around here.
Yeah, but it's different for Cass because she's really in love with him. Oh. I know you think it's a waste of time, but I think it's terrific. I mean, I drew a picture of him for her and everything. I'm going to do her hair up real nice.
Hang on. I don't like the sound of this.
Why? Just because you haven't got a chance with him?
Cass and Bobby haven't either.
Bobby?
Yeah. She's been bitten by the love bug too. Same guy. I tried to warn her off it, but love is not only blind, it is deaf too.
Oh, God. Poor Cass.
And poor Bobby too.
Yeah, well, by the time this is finished, it's going to be poor us. Those two will be at each other's throats and we're going to be stuck right in the middle.
Oh, dear.
Hello, you look like you've had a heavy day.
No, just a heavy session with Mrs. O'Regan. She's quite sure that cat was poisoned.
What makes you think that?
Apparently it happened to her cat, so now she's an expert. She said it had been salivating, and that's a sure sign. You saw him, didn't you?
Oh, yeah, but only when Cass and I were laying him out. That's possible, I suppose, but who'd want to do it? Not the ladies, they loved him.
That's what Mrs. O's worried about. She thinks he must have got into a cupboard or something and found some old rat poison she'd forgotten to get rid of.
Well, the only thing I saw Harry getting into was my milk.
Well, I think it's best if Cass goes on believing he died of natural causes, don't you?
Yeah. Don't upset her.
Well, I'm off. See you in the morning. I think maybe we'd better check the grounds in case someone threw a bait over the fence. We don't want any of the children from maternity getting hold of one.
Right.
No.
Hey, Gloria, how about trading some of your gunk with me?
I need it myself.
Come on, you've got enough to sink a ship. All I've got's a half-empty mascara and some purple eyeshadow. Oh, you'll be getting out soon. You can have all you want. What say I swap you some of my tobacco for some of your stuff?
Hey, I was just kidding. Take what you want.
I don't take nothing for nothing either. We swap or you can forget it.
Okay, have it your way. Could do with a bit of tobacco.
Oh, gee. I'll just take this and these.
And that. In bad company and again, that. Eh, Bobby?
You don't do much for me, either, smart.
What is it? Good. And you might as well leave, hadn't you, honey?
Yeah, rack off, Glor. We got things to do. I'll fix you up with the baccy later.
That's better.
Well, let's get started. I've got some stuffy.
God, Cass was really going on about Rick Manning tonight. Gee, she's got a crush on him.
Tough. Can't see him going for her.
Oh, I think you're right. Looks the sort that'd be attracted to the helpless feminine type.
And Cass sure ain't that.
Neither are you.
Oh, well, I will be when you're finished. Cass had better keep her nose right out of it.
Thought Cass was supposed to be your mate.
Of course she is. As long as she keeps her cow eyes in another paddock. Well, come on, I haven't got all night.
What do you want?
Oh, just a little chat about poison milk. Poor old Harry, now, who would do a slimy thing like that?
Well, you're asking the wrong person. I wasn't anywhere near your milk, was I, Mr. Manning?
Oh, so you know it was my milk. I thought you were behind it. You're the main one in here, figures you'd be doing the world a favour.
Well, the last point I have to agree with. But you're asking the wrong person about poison. Where would I get it?
That's easy. I noticed my old mate Birmingham paid you a visit yesterday.
Yes, he wanted to say how sorry he was about Eddie's murder. Oh, no, sorry. What was the term you used? Accident. Yes, that's right.
Eddie's death was an accident, no matter what you think.
Like Harry's. You can't prove that I had anything to do with that poisoned milk, Mr. Manning, so why don't you go and waste your time somewhere else?
No. No, I can't prove it, but I know you did it, and I won't be taking my eyes off you, not for one second.
Well, that won't help. You see, you underestimate me. You think that I didn't care about Eddie, but I'm going to prove to you that I did care. You're going to pay for his killing. Eye for an eye, Mr. Manning. Try not to forget it.
Would you?
He's looking real good, isn't he?
Leave us alone, Reb. I mean it.
Look, Sarah, it's no good going on like this. We've got to stick together in here.
I don't want to know, okay?
I'll do what I can to square it for you at the trial, I promise.
You could have done something before it got this far, but you didn't. So leave us alone.
Hey, your hair looks really nice.
Oh, I didn't think anyone had noticed.
Of course we noticed. You did a good job, Doreen.
Yeah, pity it's so short. If it had been longer, I could have done more with it, you know?
Yeah. Lovely, Doreen. Makes you look very pretty, Cass.
Oh. Could have been a hairdresser. Things just didn't work out.
Well, it's never too late, you know. You could open a salon when you get out of here. Call it the Shea Door.
Yeah, and I could get all those rich old bags in and chuck the blue rinse around.
Speaking of old bags, has anyone seen my friend?
Oh, you mean Gloria?
Mm. Seems to be staying out of the way.
Yeah, well, maybe that's the best thing for both of you, huh?
Mm-hmm. Worked out a way to get even with Reb yet?
Well, Sarah's the bait, but I don't know how I'm going to do it yet. Don't worry, though. I will.
God, I've got a hand like a foot. I need three.
Two for me.
Ta-da!
Oh! Look at you! What are you all dolled up with?
Wouldn't you like to know?
It's when you turn Ferguson on, if nothing else.
Jealous, are
you? Yeah, I think you look real pretty, Bobby.
Oh, ta.
Hey, where'd you get all the makeup? Wouldn't mind having a go with it.
Oh, it's in myself. Go for your life.
Oh, not that much.
No need to be bitching.
He's bitching.
Well, now, girls, then back to the dorms, eh?
Oh, do we have to, Mr. Manning? Thought you and me could go over the fence and have a bit of a rage at one of them classy discos.
I'm sorry, miss, but we haven't met, have we?
Oh, blimey, don't you even know me?
Mitchell! Oh, why didn't someone tell me? Now, that looks much better.
You reckon this is how blokes really like their chicks to
look? Oh, my word. If I wasn't working tonight, I might just take you to that disco. Quarter of an hour, ladies.
Would you?
Where are you going, huh?
The rec room.
Oh, save your energy. The bell's about to go. Just a minute. I think that it's about time you and I had another little chat. Now, you do realise, of course, why I arranged for you to share with Keane.
Yeah.
Well, then I think it's about time we had some action.
Well, it's not that easy. Well, these things take time. You've got to do it at the right time.
Oh, Hunt, are you religious or something? You're waiting for a divine sign.
Do it soon.
That's not good enough. I have reached the limit of my saintly patience, Hunt. I want Keen dealt with tonight.
Tonight? I can't do it tonight.
Can't?
Well, what about in the morning when they unlock the cells and Reb walks out with her face all fixed? I'll cop it for sure.
I'll be on duty in the morning, Hunt. So you've got nothing to worry about. Unless you fail me.
I wondered where you'd got to.
Oh, that door. I was trying to write to Kay. Nothing I say is going to change what happened, though.
Yeah, I reckon it's hard, all right.
Oh, I swore I'd never end up back in here again.
So did I. Never believed I'd be breaking my neck to get back in again. It's different for you, but I reckon you're going to get off, Myra. I mean, it was an accident, wasn't it?
I don't know, Dor. I just don't know. I hated what he was saying about Kay and I wanted to shut him up.
Yeah, well, I know what you mean, but you've got to be careful about saying those sort of things, Myra, because if any of it came out in court, well, you'd be a goner.
Yeah, I know, love. Doesn't make writing to Kay any easier, though. I mean, how can I tell her I didn't mean to do it when I just don't know myself?
Hey, listen, how about you come and watch the telly with me for a bit? Take your mind off it.
Now, the bitch that caused it all's in here, too.
Yeah, Judy told me.
She wasn't satisfied with stealing my husband. She had to take my daughter as well.
Well, she can't do much while she's in here. And you just got to stay away from her. No point getting in any deeper than you already are.
Yeah, I know, love. It's going to be hard, though. Very, very hard. Hey, let's go and watch some telly. See how the rest of the world's coping.
It's no good, Colleen. It's got to stop.
What?
You're drinking. I mean, you just can't come home every night and drink yourself silly.
Yes, I can. I have to. I don't want to think about anything he wouldn't understand.
I understand more than anyone else you know. I lost Bill the same way, remember? I know it's horrible and it's unfair, but wallowing in booze and self-pity will not bring Patrick and the children back. Now, I've got beautiful memories of Bill. I didn't get them out of a bottle.
Yes. You're right, all right. Here, I'll give you a hand.
Oh, bugger it. I'm sorry. I just can't handle it anymore, Colleen. Either you go on the wagon or you'll have to find somewhere else to live.
No, you can't do that.
I don't want to. But unless you stop drinking, you give me no choice.
Please, please don't say that, Meg. You're my friend.
Yes, I am. And that's why I'm trying to straighten you out before you go too far. It's only going to be a matter of time before someone finds out at work that you've got a drinking problem.
Oh, well, they already have.
Who?
Well, it doesn't matter.
Well, tell me, Colleen. I mean, I can't help you if you're not honest with me.
One of the women picked my pocket in the kitchen, took a flask of vodka.
Oh, no.
Oh, it's all right. They gave it back to me. Parker, she gave it back to me. She said that she didn't want me to get caught with it by Ferguson, someone.
And what if she had? Can you imagine it?
Well, she didn't, did she?
No, not this time. But I bet by now every woman in the prison knows. Oh, can't you see what you stand to lose?
It's all right, I can. But it won't happen because I won't let it happen. Look, I've finished with it, all right? I promise you, I've finished with it.
Look, we can get you some help, some counselling.
Look, I don't need counselling. I've just told you, for God's sake, Meg, I've finished, all right?
Trying to improve your mind, Hunt.
It's just something to read.
Love stories. I'm surprised. I thought you'd be more the physical type.
Wouldn't know.
Yeah, well, I better let you get your rest. Gonna need your energy.
was that all about?
How would I know what goes on in her head?
Come on, Phyllis, don't act dumb with me. You've been acting funny all day. What's going on between you and her?
Geez, Reb, it's not my fault.
What's not?
Well, the reason she put me in here with you is because she wants me to bash you for what you did to her old man.
Well, you better get on with it then, hadn't you?
I don't want to do nothing to you.
Because you know what you would get for trying. And you'll cop the kidnapping rap.
Calm down, will you? I know all that. And I got the freak on me back. I can't win.
Your choice, mate.
Listen, I haven't got any choice. And she comes in here tomorrow and you haven't been bashed on for it.
Yeah. Maybe. I think there's a way out. For both of us.
Ugh. It's about time they changed the rocks in this bed. These ones are getting hard.
No such thing as a bad bed, Dorcas. Some are better than others.
Yeah, and some have got men in them.
Oh, well, I don't know. I've slept in worse places.
Oh, yeah, but you're a country girl, Cass. You've slept with the chooks. That's how come you got them funny feet, you know, hanging on to the perch.
Oh, geez, you got some funny ideas about country people, Dor.
Oh, no.
What is it? What's the matter?
Oh, Helen, look what someone's done to me picture. It's a mess.
Oh, what a rotten trick.
Oh, it's ruined.
Well, don't worry about it, Cass. I'll draw you another one. It'll be much better than that.
Oh, well, thanks, Dor, but, geez, I'd like to get my hands on whoever done this.
Yeah, it's a mongrel thing to do.
Yeah. Who would it be anyway? I mean, nobody knew I had it except us.
Well, good night, girls.
She stopped outside the door.
Good. Just don't try it, you bitch.
Ah! Stop it! You're off your head!
Shut up!
Oh! Oh, stop! Oh!
You two, get out to the showers. What's the matter with you, Keane?
Oh, I fell out of bed. Yeah, I don't know if I can work today, Miss Ferguson. I broke something for sure.
Don't try that on me, Keane. A few bruises won't hurt you. Mm. You'll be a new woman after a nice hot shower. Get out.
Warn you, Keane, keep your mouth shut.
Okay, you lot, get a move on. Quick, smart now.
It was the lousy thing you did to Cass's picture.
Well, it wasn't a painting or nothing.
You still shouldn't have done it.
Yeah, well, you better not dob on me if you still want me to help you talk to Bert.
Had a noise coming from their cell last night.
Yeah, she looks like they've had a disagreement.
Huh. Look at Phyllis, there's not a mark on it. I think Reb would have gotten a punch or two, don't you?
Walking together, too. They don't seem very upset with each other. Do you think it's a setup or what?
I don't know, but I'm going to make it my business to find out.
Come on, don't overdo it. You'll have the other screws asking questions.
So, fell out of bed, right?
Ready? Don't want to be late.
No. All right. Listen, I've just got a couple of things to collect. Why don't you go and start the car?
Right. Don't forget to lock the door, will you?
Mm. Of course not.
Girls,
don't encourage them.
Get a move on, you lot, and
chatter.
Give us a back, you
bitch. Hey, you want to look at him? You little mongrel, talking about double crossing.
What the hell's going on here?
Oh, well, she said I could have a Walkman if I gave me fags. Now she won't even let me look at
That's bull. I don't know nothing about no deal. Look, I can't talk now, but what about meeting me in the library at 3?
Okay, well, what's all this about?
What do you reckon, lover?
Well, you won me. I'll see you at 3.
Okay.
I have had enough of you and that damn contraption, Mitchell. Any more trouble and I'll see that it's confiscated permanently.
It wasn't my fault.
Oh, Mr. Burns,
right, that's it. Off to the governor.
You'd better be careful. If Bobby went to that much trouble, the chances are she's doing it for your benefit.
Oh, I don't think so. It's just a bit of fun, that's all.
Well, I wouldn't bet on it. I'm surprised it hasn't happened before.
I don't quite see myself as Mitchell's type, do you?
Who knows? I mean, you wouldn't want her to do a pixie on us and line you up as a prospective husband, that's all.
I've forgotten all about Pixie.
Oh, she's probably collected another dozen husbands by now.
You all right, Colleen? You look tired.
Yeah, I am a little. I didn't sleep well last night.
Let's go.
Hope you're proud of yourself.
What do you mean?
Look at her. I thought you were supposed to be mates. Now, I'm serious, Bobby. If you don't do something to help cheer her up, I'm going to tell her that you wrecked a picture.
Oh, you wouldn't.
Oh?
You would. Yeah, all right. I was feeling pretty rotten about it anyway. And I've won Ricky, baby, so that'll be bad enough
for us. Excuse me. I wouldn't get my hopes up too high if I were you, kid.
You heard what he said last night. Hey, Cass. Reckon your hair looked real cute last night.
Thanks, Bobby.
And I meant what I said. You can borrow any of me makeup any time you like.
Yeah? Oh, geez, you're a good mate. Thanks.
Oh, no worries.
Oh, Reb, you're losing your touch. You're limping on the other leg at breakfast.
Well, how do you know?
I was worried about you. I took special notice.
Bull.
Pick a leg. Any leg.
Even I could do better than that.
I think I might be able to use that against her. Get her to tell the truth about the bus. I'm going to need Sarah to help, though.
Stephen, you've got a visitor.
Oh, who is it?
Your mother. Come on.
Well, I'm surprised to see you, Mum.
I really am.
I thought it was time to let bygones be bygones, dear.
Just exactly who are you?
Lionel Fellows sent me.
Oh, really? How nice. Tell her I'm sorry the hit failed on Manning, but if he wants, I'll do it again.
No, too risky. Anyhow, Manning's no big problem anymore.
Then what does Lionel want with me?
He's going to keep his promise and spring you.
Spring me? But that doesn't make sense.
It does to him. He reckons you've got the brains to be useful to him on the outside.
Well, I'll do my best. How's he going to do it?
We're going to organise a transfer to Barnhurst.
Is it easy to get out of there?
Don't worry about it. Lionel knows what he's doing.
I'm sure he does. Just make sure he gets me out of here.
Hello, Sarah. How's Joey?
Oh, good, thanks, Judy. He's sleeping now.
Yeah, he's a cute little kid.
Thanks. Pity about his living quarters.
Yeah. Listen, Sarah, would you like to get back at Reb for what she did to you?
I don't have anything to do with her at all.
Just hear me out, okay?
Okay.
Now, she's up to something. I'm not sure what it is. But she's going around saying she's been bashed.
Why would she do that?
Oh, she'd have her reasons. But what I want you to do is to tell her that we're on to her, that we know it's just a stunt.
She'll get suspicious if I start talking to her again.
I don't think so. Not when you tell her that we're really going to bash her, frame you, and make it look as though you did it.
Well, why would she believe you'd want to frame me?
Because she obviously likes you, Sarah. You're the best way to get at her, and she knows it.
Are you really being blamed for something she did?
God's truth, Sarah.
All right. I'll do it.
Where are you going, Mitchell?
To the Loomises, pal.
Well, where are all the others?
Cass has gone to the loo, Stevens has got a visitor, and Jude's on skip duty.
All right, off you go. Don't take all day.
Yes,
oh, come on, get on with it.
She all right?
No. I reckon she's been on the bottle again.
Bugger, she must be going through hell.
How'd you go with Reno?
Geez, you should have been there. The freak started lying through her teeth, you know, making up things I've never even heard of. Mind you, some of them
what
were pretty good.
What did you get?
Just what I wanted. I front the VJ this afternoon, and I reckon I'll get those 2 extra weeks for sure.
Bobby, now, I'm an officer and you're an inmate. Now, look, that's not what I meant. Look, I went along with that joke last night because I thought that's all it was, just a joke. But you obviously didn't, so we better put a stop to this before we both end up in a lot of trouble.
But you're my fella. I can't think of nothing else.
Look, I'm not your fella. I'm the only fella. See, and you're getting a bit confused. Now, Bobby, you're going to get out of here. You're a great kid. You'll get out of here, meet some bloke, and really make something of your life.
But I thought you liked me.
I do. But that doesn't mean I love you.
It's because I'm not good enough for you, isn't it? You'd never take up with the crimp.
That has nothing to do with it. Oh, you still don't understand, do you?
I understand. You know something else, Mr. Manning? Just like every other bloke I ever met. Bastard!
Take it that is yours.
It's the first visit you've had from your mother since you've been here, isn't it?
Yes, it was good to see her again.
How'd she take the news of your husband?
Good. In fact, she's organising all the legal details.
Oh, well. Perhaps it'll help to bring them...
Mr. Manning's after me. He knocked me around. He tried to rape me.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. The sun still shines and the rain falls down, but the sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around, last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known. Face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow. They don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes around.